Now it is very important, and it protects intellectual property by enhancing the commercial capacity to make it accessible to a broad population. Entrepreneurship provides an avenue through which regional, social, and economic development is established. Regional integration links higher education with many stakeholders in the society. It has different benefits to the students. It is the process through which students are equipped for the real world that has many complexities, uncertainties, and opportunities. The world to which students are prepared for is characterized changing status in context, job, and occupation. The country experiences financial and employment problems. There is a need to generate a population that will create new employment opportunities rather than relying on already established opportunities. Students exist in social units that require skills to meet their social needs. Entrepreneurship provides knowledge that develops responsible people in the social and family life. So entrepreneurship should be incorporated in the strategy of an institution. This means that these institutions should consider themselves as entrepreneurial entities, therefore their environment should be held together by a common mission. So entrepreneurial culture and activities should be established within the strategy. So entrepreneurs are more probably made rather than born. Mistakes, hard work, and the consistent of this attitude combined with appropriate support at the right time don't constitute a magic formula. And research found that entrepreneurship will exhibit a belief that events results directly from an individual's own behavior, a strong internal locus of control, and an ability to recognize opportunity, along with taking calculated risks and endurance. So the personal characteristics of entrepreneurs contribute to their willingness to innovate, determination, and success. Individuals with a high level of self-efficacy believe that they are capable of achieving a goal. So there are many likely to be optimistic, having an internal locus of control and emotional stability. So individuals with a high need for success will achieve more by setting goals based on their experience and ability. So besides, entrepreneur always look for a new opportunity to exploit familiar ones using various methods. Moreover, entrepreneur often show a greater willingness to tolerate ambiguity. They assume that while unable to make fully accurate prediction about the future, they can take action to make a better one. So higher educational institution, here the students have the capability of solving problems and taking creative strategic decisions based on valid and reliable data. The resulting impact is likely to be that the business will operate with high accountability. Therefore, young entrepreneurs should be able to manage their commercial concerns successfully in the long term. So the main point for this successful this entrepreneurship is mainly, number one, resolute motivation and passion, and number two, risk-taking ability, and number three, creative thinking, four, persistence, and five, self-discipline. So these are the keys for success of this entrepreneurship. And so I want to speak a few words about the Department of Home Science of our college. All of we know that Home Science Department has done many things for the college, and some training program has already been done. And here in our college, there are some vocational courses in which our students and our teachers are working. Say cutting, tailoring is there, food processing, and this spoken English also is there. So we can, after passing the BA examination, our student can do any job in otherwise they can open themselves for business. They can go and self-dependent, they may be self-dependent. So these are the good thing for the department. So I again thankful to my colleague and my students of this department, and I hope that our resource person will give some instruction how to motivate our students for these things. So with this few words, I declared his training program open to all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Bhuiya sir, for your inspiring and motivating speech and inaugural speech. Now I request Dr. Ananya Kashyap, another coordinator of this today's WBT program, to introduce today's resource person, and after that she will hand over the mic to our resource person for her presentation. Thank you very much.
Thank you
Dr. Pulaj. A very good morning everyone. I'm Dr. Ananya Kashyap, assistant professor, Department of Home Science. Here we are to start our web-based training program on dyeing and printing using natural dyes. For that, today we have Dr. Sumita Borua among us. Firstly, let me introduce her with you all. Dr. Sumita Borua is presently working as an assistant professor in the Department of Textile and Apparel Designing, Assam Agricultural University, Jorhat, from February 2019. Previously, she was working in Assam Women's University, Jorhat, as an assistant professor from September 2014 to February 2019. She was also working as a faculty member in JD Institute of Fashion Technology, Guwahati, chapter from 2011 to August 2014. She did her PhD on the topic evaluation of twill weave fabrics made of blended AB model and airy acrylic yarns suitable for different dress designs from Assam Agricultural University in the year 2018. She has 14 research papers and 8 articles under her name. She has guided 6 numbers of students as manager guide and 9 students as home. She is a member of Assam Science Society, Assam Agricultural University branch, and was acting as an assessor for Prime Minister Kaushal Vikas Yojana in Northeast region under Radiation Infinite Program from August 2016 to December 2019. On behalf of Department of Home Science, I welcome you to this web-based training program, and you are requested to start the session. Thank you.
Over to you, Sumita. Thank you. Thank you, Ananya ma'am. Good morning, respected principal of HCV Girls College, Gulaghat, Assam, Dr. Vipul Chandra Bhuiya sir, Dr. Paula Sandiksa, HOD of the Home Science Department, Dr. Anita Thakur ma'am, Dr. Ananya Kachya ma'am, and today participants. At the very outset, I would like to convey heartiest thanks to the IQAC and the Department of Home Science, HCV Girls College, Gulaghat, for giving me an opportunity to be a part of your web-based training program. Today, I am going to explain you about dyeing and printing of textiles using natural dyes. As you all know, most of the fabrics we use have synthetic dyes, which are harmful for our human body. So the demand of natural dyes increases day by day. In this training program, I will explain you what the natural fiber yarn and what the natural dyes and various sources of natural dyes, extraction method and its application on fabric. My training program will be having 2 sessions. First, we start the theory session followed by the practical session. So without wasting our time, let's start the theory session.
Ma'am, do you have any PPT?
Yeah.
Oh. Well,
okay, we start the theory session. The topic of Today the presenting topic is my dyeing and painting of textiles using natural dyes. Dyeing and painting are an important finishing method which provides beauty, luster, softness, durability of the fabric. The main ingredient of dyeing and painting is dye. Dye is an organic compound responsible for color of the dyed or painted textile fiber material compound fused on a substance in more or less permanent state. There are two main classes of dye. It are indigenous or natural dye and synthetic or chemical dye. Dyeing is the most delightful textile art, which are important brands in apparel designing. Dyeing of fabric takes place in three stages. The first appearance of the dye, the surface of the fiber. The second is the penetration of dye into the fiber. And the last is fixation of the dye. In order to achieve three phases, the fabric must swell to allow the dye to be absorbed. This is carried out by the water in the dye bath and raising the temperature. The dye penetration is the fabric is then fixed by the addition of salt and acids. It is the most important point. The absorption is then depends upon the role of water action of electrolyte effect of temperature and pH value of the dye bath. Due to the health hazards and environmental problems, the use of synthetic dyes, the people realize the utility of natural dyes and move toward it with scientific background. Thus, the interest in natural dyes has been revived. What is natural dyes? Natural means which come from natural sources. Natural dyes are dyes or coloring derived from plants, animals, or minerals. It basically comes from the natural sources. The majority of natural dyes are vegetable dyes from plant sources such as root, berries, bugs, leaves, and other organic sources. Then, origin of natural dye. It is known since ancient time and it was found in China date 2600 BC. Every product has advantages and disadvantages. First, we discussed about the advantages of natural dyes. Natural dyes are produced soft, lustrous and human eye-catching dye effect. The when two natural dye stuff are mixed, it creates totally new colors, which are not easily possible with synthetic dye stuff. Natural dye produced color are rare and harmonizing. Natural dyes are agro-renewable and at the same time biodegradable. Natural dyes like Harda, Indigo, etc. waste are an ideal fertilizer for use in agricultural field. This is a labor-intensive industry, thereby providing the opportunity for all those engaged in cultivation, extraction, and application of these dyes on textiles. Some of its constituents are anti-allergens, hence proved safe for skin content and are mostly non-hazardous of human health. Some of the natural dyes are enhanced with age, while synthetic dyes fade with time. Natural dyes are usually moth-proof and can replace synthetic dyes in kids' garments for safety.
Sorry to interrupt, ma'am, but slides are not visible.
Slides are not visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you sure?
You can present your slide.
Yes, is it?
Whether you are using a laptop or mobile, ma'am?
Mobile.
From mobile?
Yes.
Again, you present. Again, you present now. You go to the present now.
Yeah.
Now it is visible. Right? Now it is visible. Yeah. You can continue.
Okay.
Yes, you can continue.
Okay, thank you. Despite these advantages, Nisa Eldize to carry some inherent disadvantages. The disadvantages of natural dyes are it is difficult to reproduce shapes by using natural dyes coloring, as these agro products vary from one crop season to another crop season, place to place and species to species, maturity period, etc. It is difficult to standardize a recipe for the use of natural dyes, as the natural dye process and its color develop depends not only on the color component but also on the it depends upon the materials. Nisal line required.
Sunita.
Yes, ma'am.
Your slide is again visible. You just
again invisible.
Oh, it's not visible.
Okay, wait, ma'am. It's here.
No.
In ako.
Same.
Hello, Mister Varo.
Okay, it is visible now.
Full screen,
did you? You can go. You can continue.
And I can go. Full screen, one I can do that.
Madam Bora, you can continue. Madam Bora. You can continue.
Yeah, okay. Natural dyeing requires skilled workmanship and is therefore expensive. Low color yield of source natural dye thus necessitates the use of more dye stuff, larger dyeing time, and excessive cost of modern and modern thing. Scientific background of large part of the science involved in natural dyeing is still need to be explored. Then classification of natural dyes. Natural dyes can be broadly classified into three sections: vegetable, animal, and indigo pigment. Thus, in the term, natural dyes cover all the dyes derived from the natural sources like plant, insect, and minerals. There are various types of classifications. The first one is classification of natural dye based on affinity. It's two types: substantive and adjective. The substantive dyes do not need a model to color the fiber. And adjective dyes are those dyes that require a model to bind the color to the fiber. The example of the substantive dyes are indigo, turmeric, which need no model when during the dyeing time. And adjective dyes, example, Ojunbak, pomegranate, modar, logwood, cochineal, and fustic, etc., which are available locally available in our Assam. Then classifications of natural dyes based on structure based. The indigo announced it create blue and purple dyes, and terraquinins, most of the most important red dye, modar, lay, cochineal, kames, etc. Alpha nephaquinins, it comes from the henna and walnut, etc. Flap ones, most of the yellow dyes, turmeric, well, kumkum, tissue, onion, etc. under this. Dihydroparanal, logwood, brazilwood, etc. Anthocyanidian, it's a begonia, sika, arabinia, etc. Carotenoids, carrot, sindur, kesar, etc. Polyhydric phenols, it's a tannin. It's produced brown, gray, and black dyes, which are marbolum and pomegranate, etc. Then again, classification of natural dye based on application. First one is modern dye. Most of the natural dyes are modern dye. For example, modar, logwood, cochineal, etc. Then direct dye. Many of the natural dyes are direct dye. Turmeric, pomegranate, annatto, safflower, etc. Acid dyes, saffron, basic dyes, berberin, and bed dyes, underbed dyes, indigo, wood, etc. And dispersed dyes, which are available in our Assam henna. Then, according to the Sivanga et al. 2011, natural dyes are again classified in different ways. First one is according to the color. It's divided into three color portions, red, blue, and yellow. Then, according to the chemical structure, natural dyes again classified. Natural dyes, amine, castine, polymethyl, anthraquinate, flavine, and indigoid. And according to the sources, natural dyes divided into three categories, animals, minerals, plants, and again, plants are divided into four categories, bark, roots, leaves, and fruits. Then, mordant. What is mordant? The word mordant has been derived from the Latin word morderia, which means to bite. The chemical which increase natural dye upcome by the textile fiber is called mordant. Different types of mordant yield different colors, even for the same natural dye. Therefore, final color, their brilliancy, and color fastness properties are not only depend on the dye itself, but are also determined by varying concentration and skillful manipulation of the mordant. Thus, a mordant is more important than the dye stuff. There are two types of mordant: natural mordant dyes and synthetic mordant dyes. Then, under the natural mordants, first one is alum. It's an example of natural mordants. Alum, the specific compound is hydrate potassium alum sulfate, found in local supermarket as it is often used in canning and preserving. Alum is one of the most popular mordants used in natural dyeing. Alum is also regarded as the safest of the common mordants. So alum is natural, but too much of it can make yarn sticky. So lace is best. The images of alum mordant. Then iron. Iron tends to darken the dye fiber. Cream turtle can be used along with iron to fix it on animal fiber. Boiled in water will create an effective and free iron modem. Iron will dull down color, so care must be taken when dyeing. Then copper. All British coins are made of copper. It is more effective. It produces same as iron. Copper produces lovely green color. Then synthetic modem. Chromium. It leaves wool soft to touch, whereas the other modem can be quite hard and slightly clumsy. Fibers dyed with modern dyes are wool, mote acrylic, and nylon. Chromium has been red listed under ECO regulations. The images of chromium modem. The cupric sulfate, known as blue vitriol, it gives some specific effect in states. The use has been limited as per the norms of the ECO standard. Then potassium dichromate, it's a synthetic modem. It is relatively more expensive and harmful for human skin. Its use has been limited as per the norms of ECO standard. It is light sensitive and changes color under light exposure. The potassium dichromate image are shown. The stannous chloride, it gives brighter colors than any other modem. They are oxidized on exposure to air and many impart a stiff hard to the fabric. Stannous chloride also causes higher loss of fabric tenacity. It means it loses the tensile strength of the fabric if used beyond a certain concentration. Then ferrous sulfate, known as green petrol, which is used to darkening of the color shades. It is easily available and one of the oldest modems known. It is extensively used to get gray to black shades. Then tin has a tendency to be very harsh on the wool and can make it quite brittle. Because of its hardness, it's used in the little amount along with another modem. When it used correctly, it leaves a clear and very fast color. Tin is highly toxic. Then come to the extraction of natural dyes. How to extract the natural dyes? First, we collect the plant material when they are at their peak of color. Then dry them in the shade. Soak all the plant materials after drying. Soak all the plant materials into small pieces. Take requested amount of material and water, depend upon the dye source, and boil, maintaining the MLR, M is to L, material liquor ratio. Then boil the mixer at least for an hour, and after that, strain the material and set the dye bud aside. Other extraction method of dye are aqueous method. Boil dye stuff in soft water at 100 degrees centigrade and filter the dye solution. And alkaline method, prepare 1% alkaline solution, which of 1 gram of sodium carbonate and sodium hydroxide in 100 ml of water at 100 degrees centigrade, and then filter the dye solution. Then acid method, prepare 1% of acetic acid solutions by adding 1 ml of hydrochloric acid in 100 ml of soft water at 100 degrees centigrade, and then filter the dye solution. And alcoholic method, add 50 ml of alcohol to 50 ml of soft water, enter the dye material and boil, and then filter the dye solution. Then ethanol method, the powder is initially defected with petroleum benzene by the required amount of ethanol by using an extra extractor for 72 hours. The extract is filtered by using filter paper and then dried at 45 degree centigrade, and extracts are kept in sterile bottles under refrigerator condition until use. And methanol method, powder is taken and extracted by 20% aqueous methanol using soft slate extraction method. The dye powder is slightly soluble in hot water and completely soluble in alkaline medium at room temperature. Then fabric can be dyed with different natural color, mostly through pre-modern tint, post-modern tint, and simultaneous modern tint. Pre-modern tint, in the pre-modern tint, this is the modern tint method. Then pre-modern tint, fabric is treated with the modern and then dye. Post-modern tint, fabric after dyeing is treated with modern and it's separate bath. And simultaneous modern tint, dyeing and modern tint process are carried out in the same bath itself. Then equipment needed for dyeing are heat source, pestle or mortar, modern tint and dyeing pen, drying rod, thermometer, measuring jugs, plastic balls and buckets, strainer, weighing scale, and protective equipment. Then preparation of fabric for dyeing. The most important and preliminary step for the preparation of fabric was to give even penetration. Fabric contains natural impurities such as stars, dust, oil, and other impurities, which are removed by the use of mild alkaline and detergents. First one is desizing process. The fabric was treated with 100% hydrochloric acid in R suitable value. M is to L 1 is to 30 means material weight 1 gram and liquor means water ratio is 30 ml to immerse the sample for 5 to 10 minutes. Sample were removed, squeezed lightly and kept covered. Next day, the samples were removed, washed thoroughly and kept for drying in set. Then scouring method. Desizing fabric was boiled in a solution containing 20% soap and 2% soda ash. At material to liquor ratio was 1:30 and boiled for 2 hours. After scouring, the material was squeezed and washed thoroughly in hot water, followed by cold water and then dried in air. Then the fabric was ironed to remove wrinkles. Then preparation of silk fabric for dyeing. Degumming is the process of removal of gum from silk. Silk becomes luster and feels smooth after degumming. Due to the presence of silk gum, the raw silk is difficult to dye uniformly due to the less penetration of dye and other chemical and solution on the material. Airy silk and other silk fabric were first weighted accurately and immersed into the water. M is to L ratio is 1:50. Required quantity of washing soda, that is 5 gram per liter, was added to water and stirred having to the 50 degree centigrade. After 30 minutes, the fabric was taken out, the wash properly in running water and then air dried. Then dyeing procedure, depending on the set depth requirement, modern and dye concentration are to be determined. The fabric to be dyed was weighted and soaked in water for 5 minutes for even dyeing. In the pre-modern tint method, the samples are entered in the dye bath at 60 to 80 degrees centigrade and M:L ratio is 1:20 and raise the temperature up to optimum dyeing temperature, maybe 90 degrees centigrade. Dyeing is then continued for further 30 to 40 minutes, followed by thorough rinsing, chopping, and washing. In the postmodern tint system, of applying natural color on fabric, dyeing is done at optimum dyeing conditions, and the dyed samples are dipped into the modern bath containing mainly 1 to 2% metal salt for true color development, followed by rinsing, soaping, and throat washing. Then come to the printing part. The printing of fabric represents an important part of the textile industry, and it produces more colorful. It is produced more colorful effect on the fabric. It was practiced in India thousands of years before the Christian era. Printing is application of color in the form of design, which can be done by hand or machine. Hand printing is of two types, that is block printing and screen printing. The machine printing are classified as direct roller printing, dissolved printing, resist printing, pigment printing, and etc. This is the classifications of printing: direct printing, resist printing, dissolved printing, and block printing. Then block printing. Block printing is a process of transferring an ink image from a surface cut in relief to paper, fabric, or other material. The printing block is often a wood, and the ink is a paste or liquid carrying pigment or dye. The image transfer is made by pressure applied by any one of the several methods. The process varies in technical details in both fine arts and craft applications. The history of block printing is oldest type of printing and has been around for thousands of years. Then materials required for block printing: wooden blocks, fabric, block printing color, liquid or powder, binder, color, fixer, gloves, disposable plate, glasses, and spoons, half meter sheet. And this is the block printing dye, liquid and pigments, color fixer, and binder paste. And this is the images of different wooden blocks of different shapes and sizes. Then process of block printing. This is fairly easy process. All you need to do is that add 1 teaspoon of block printing color in 4 teaspoon of binder in a glass and mix it well to make a paste. All we need to do is to pick the color with a spoons and directly apply it on the wooden block. After that, block directly on the cloth wherever you want to motif or design to be, and press the block or tap the block with palm of your hand. You will notice that once you pick up the block again, the motif or design gets transferred on the cloth with your choice of color. Repeat the same process again and make a many design that you can the block. This is block printing techniques. Then now I discuss about the screen printing. Originally, this technique was referred to as silk screen printing because the screens were made of fine, strong silk thread. Today, there are also made of nylon, polyester, vinyl, and metal. Screen printing is done with the use of either flat or cylinder screen. Each screen design may be drawn by hand, and a coating of liquor or other impermeable substance applied to all parts of the screen that are not part of its design. Today, the design is photographed and the negative is used for its sanitized screen to opaque or block out those areas not part of the screen's color design. Each screen is then fitted into a wooden or metal frame. The printing paste or dye is poured on the screen and forced through its unblocked area onto the fabric with a rubber edge squeeze. The frame is then raised and placed on the next section of the fabric, and the operation is repeated until the entire length of the cloth is printed with that particular color. The hand screen printing is time consuming and limited to relatively short length, about 60 yards of fabric. The important characteristics of screen printing is that a greater thickness of ink can be applied to the substrate as compared to the other printing techniques. This allows for various interesting effects that cannot be achieved through the other printing method. This is a screen printing technique, which is done by hand. And this is a screen, then how to its procedure and different types of screen. Then let's about the tie and dye. The Indian, Africa, and Japanese word bandhana, adai, and sibori, meaning the tie and dye, have been used for centuries. Tie and dye is the process of folding, twisting, pleating, or crumpling fabric or a garment and binding with string or rubber band, followed by application of dye. Tie and dye is the resist dyeing process for creating attractive color design on fabric. This is achieved by knotting, binding, folding, or sewing certain parts of the cloth in such a way that the dye cannot penetrate into this area when the cloth is dyed. It is a hand process by which intricate and attractive pattern can be produced. Then history of tie and dye. It is impossible to say where this technique originated, but India is a strong candidate on the basis of available information. According to some references, it first developed in Jaipur in the form of lehria. Bandhani dates back of the Indus Valley civilization in the Bronze Age. Then the materials and equipment required for tie and dye work are listed below. First, fabric or garment, basins, bowls, stove, large wooden spoons or long wooden sticks, teaspoon, small pair of scissors, white thread reel, common shawl, color dye, dexi, it's a aluminium, knitting needle, pointed pencil, hairpin. The process of tie and dye are, first, wash the fabric, means scout the fabric, then dry it and then iron it. Prepare the cloth for tie and dye for knotting, binding, folding, sewing, etc., or a combination of these, always keeping one side on the outside of the bundle. Prepare the dye and taste for the color. That wet the sample if necessary and place it in the dye bath for the required length of the time. Remove the fabric from the dye bath and squeeze out surplus dye. Rinse the dyed fabric in water and keep on rinsing till the water is clear. Squeeze out surplus water and hang up to dry. Tie and dyeing sample always hang out. When a second or third color is to be dyed, tie up the samples again and add more binding where the previous color is to be preserved, repeating the dyeing process for each subsequent color. After the final dyeing and rinsing, the fabric should be dried quickly. Then the samples are untied. rinse again if necessary and partially dye. And after that, iron the fabric while still damp. Collect and tie together any length of the thread which can be used again. Then binding method of the tie and dye. First one is spot technique. Pick up tiny piece of fabric with needle, then wrap swing thread around directly below needle and tie tightly, and after that remove the needle and dip in the dye and remove thread. And circular technique, pick up center of circle and smooth folds form from it, binding and then dye. After dyeing, untie the samples and then dry. Then radius of the circle is determined by the distance from the portion to the bottom of the binding. Then square technique, fold fabric lengthwise through center, then again fold crosswise and then bind and then dye, untie and dry. Then pleated oval, fold the fabric in half along center line of oval using cardboard pattern of half an oval, trace outline on fabrics. With fingers, pleat both thickness together along this line, forming a fan shape. And then bind, tie, untie, and dye. Then marbling, makes a beautiful hazy background for other media, such as stationery and block printing. Squeeze fabric up into a ball, bind in all directions until it is very hard. Dip in dye and remove, untie and dye. Lines of stripes, to make irregular stripes, randomly pleated or fold fabric lengthwise, again crosswise and diagonal. And then bind the fabrics and then dye, untie and dry. Then ruchi, fold fabric along center of stripes, place a line of machine stitching below fold forming a kasi, only large enough to slip a ruler or piece of wood through. Slip crushing over wood and gather all the fabric up at one end of the stick. And after that it binds and dye. Remove binding and machine stitching. And little box, accuracy in folding is most important. Fold fabric once in direction of strap according pleat at right angles to the first fold. Pleat in opposite direction to pleat just made and then bind and dye. Open unbound ends during dyeing to let dye reach inner folds. Then knotting, use fine fabric for this. Roll or fold up fabric into a string, then tie it into knots and dye. An alternate method is to tie a thick rope into knots and roll or fold cloth around it, and then bind to the rope and dye. Trick tuck, begin with the design of simple lines. Use strong swing thread and make a big knot in the end. Follow the outline with small running stitches. Gather the fabric very tightly on this thread and secure with a big knot. Dip quickly in and out of the dye, remove threads and then dry. In my next slide, I am going to present before you different tie techniques and finish tie and dye samples so that you can easily understood them. This is the sample of tie spot technique and right hand side the samples of finally tie and dye samples of spot techniques and circular techniques. And square techniques, how to fold the fabrics and bind it and finish square techniques fabrics. And marbling, how to bind the marbling techniques and finish marbling techniques. Lines of stripes, how to fold the fabrics, and then bind and finish lines of stripes, and knotting techniques, and finish knotted materials. And trick tuck, it is a stitching process, trick tuck, how to make a trick tuck and finish trick tuck tie-dye materials. Then dyeing, how to dye a tie fabrics. To prepare the dye fabric, calculate how big a pot you need to accommodate the fabric. Big enough so that the material is not crowded. Fill the pot with hot water, then add the dye, mixing according to the instruction on the type of dye used. Follow proper instruction for a particular dye in use, as some dyes need salt and some cold fix. Some dyes require things to be soaked for 3 hours, some for only half an hour. After the fabric has soaked for the required time, remove it from the pot without removing. Then rinse fabric under cool running water until all excess dye has been washed away. When the water runs clear, remove the resist material and rinse the fabric once more. Again, until the water runs clear. Hang up to dry, but keep out of direct sunlight. Then precautions during tie-dyeing process. First one is binding must be wrapped and tied tightly to get good color variation. For consistent result, the fabric should be damp when it is tied and when it is dyed. Fabric may be rinsed under cold water after dyeing. This gives a more hazy effect than unrinsed work. When dyeing with two or more colors, fabric may be dyed one color, then dried. Then dye the other color, or may be dipped in one color immediately after the other color. The latter method gives softer edges and more evenly mixed color when the two color overlap. When dyeing several colors, dip just the part where you want each color to be, not the whole thing. Then some common sources of natural dye. Turmeric, common name turmeric, botanical name Curcuma longa. Turmeric has been used in Asia from thousands of years. It is commonly known term from Indian saffron. First used as a dye, then later as a medicinal plant, dye extract from roots. It produces yellow to orange color depending upon the modern use. The images of fresh turmeric, then dyed form and powder form. Then Ketesu, common name cut, Ketesu, Kala and Katha, botanical name. Acacia Ketesu, trade name B, natural dye, brown dye stuff for textile. Ketesu is purified extract of wood Acacia Ketesu. The plant of Acacia Ketesu is about 15 meters. And Ketesu is among tip and extract from the natural dye. It gives light brown to good brown with acceptable fastness rating. The images of plant Ketesu. The fruits also used as a dye, which is used as a katha powder. Then Mirabolam, common name Harat and Harda, and botanical name Terminalia sebula, trade name Karel, and our local name is Hilika. And natural dye, greenish yellow dye stuff and natural modern for textiles. Then Mirabolan is a fruit, is fruits of tree Terminalia sabula. This is used as a greenish yellow dye stuff for textile. This is also used as a natural mordant in many cases. This is also used as a substitute of tannic acid. The images of face, harda, and dry form, and then brown form. And leg, common name leg or leg dye, botanical name Feria leca, trade name Nimbus, natural dye red and violet dye stuff for textile. Leg is probably most ancient of all animal dyes. The dye is taken from insect Feria leca. This insect is cultivated on kusum and tissue trees. This has its history of use of natural dye in South Asia and India since the beginning of recorded history. The dye set exhibited very good fastness to washing, rubbing, and light. The images of leg dye and its dye powder form. And pomegranate, common name pomegranate or anar, botanical name Punica granatum, trade name Melau, natural dye yellow dye stuff for textile. Pomegranate is one of the most largely consumed fruits in Asia. The dye is extracted from its fruit rind. The colors obtained exhibited good fastness to washing, to rubbing, and light. At times, this dye is also used as a mordant and is over-dyed and other natural dyes to improve fastness of leather. The images of face pomegranate fruits and skin of pomegranate fruits, dyed skin of pomegranate fruits, and after its ground form. Then annatto, the common name sinduri or sinduria, botanical name Bixa aurelia, and natural dye obtained from it orange color. Among the naturally occurring colorants, an important one is annatto. It is a carotenoid-based dye extract from the outer coating of the seed of the Bixa aurelina. The color obtained exhibited good fastness to washing, rubbish, and dye. The images of the fruits of annatto and dried seed of annatto and powdered form seed of annatto. Then henna, common name mehndi or henna, botanical name Lawsonia inermis, and color obtained from henna is red to orange. Henna is widely used in the cosmetic industry as dyeing agent. It consists of face or dried leaves of the plant Lawsonia inermis. It has medical importance along dyeing properties. As a face leaf or dry form. And madder. Common name madder and magista and magist. Botanical name Rubia cardifolia in India madder and Rubia tinctoria in European madder. Madder is one of the oldest natural dyes. Alizarin is main chemical compound that helps in produce the red color. Cultivation of madder needs subtropical climates and prefer more soil. It is cultivated in the foods of Himalaya in huge quantity. Dye extracted from its roots and is red color. And images of madder flower and the dry madder roots and its powder form.
रात को कितने बजे सोते हो?
Then arjun tree. Common name Arjuna tree, botanical name.
और सुबह देर को उठते हो?
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. हेलो ओके अर्जुन जी ओके ओके थैंक यू सर अर्जुन जी कॉमन नेम अर्जुना ट्री botanical name Terminalia arjuna the arjuna is about 20 to 25 meters tall usually has a basket trunk it has a oblong conical leaves which are green on the top it is highly medical plant it has pale yellow flower which appear between march and june its fibrous woody fruit divided into five wings appears between september and november defiant shade light to dark brown and brownish black are obtained. Arjuna tree, in the Arjuna tree, Arjun bark are used as a dye form. Then, importance of colorfulness properties. Textile fabric has many properties. Colorfulness properties is one of the most important properties of them. It is an important indicator to measure the color of a dyed or printed textile to fade or bleed under various types of influence such as washing, light, rubbing, and pressing. Then colorfulness to washing, it followed the ASTM standard 1968 methods. It done on the laundrometers. The colorfulness to washing of the textile material is determined by treating the test specimen in the specific detergent at a specific temperature and liquor ratio for a given time. The specimen is attached to the standard multifiber stripes so that the color, strain, as well as shade sense can be assessed. Then, colorfulness to light. It followed the ASTM standard 1968 method. The samples were evaluated for color sense after 48 hours of exposure of sunlight. The intervals of exposure of sunlight being 8 hours, 16 hours, 24 hours, 32 hours, 40 hours, and 48 hours. The effect of the color of the test specimen were expressed in the international grayscale by grading the sample 1 to 5. 1 means very poor, 2 poor, 3 fair, very fair, good, and excellent. And colorfulness to rubbing. Rubbing colorfulness refer to the ability to sustain original color of dyed fabric when rubbing. It's a two method, dry rubbing and wet rubbing. Dry rubbing colorfulness refer to the suitable of fat and staining of the dyed fabric when rubbed with the standard white cloth. And the wet rubbing colorfulness referred to the situation of the fabric and staining the dyed fabrics when rubbed with a standard white cloth, which water content is 95 to 105%. The evaluation of rubbing colorfulness depends on the degree of staining of white cloth. After testing, the white cloth is compared to staining samples, but to measure staining firstness. Rubbing color firstness, same as washing color firstness, divided into 5 grades, among which grade 5 is the best and grade 1 is the worst. The friction fading of fabric is to make dye fall off caused by friction. Wet rubbing is influenced by the both external force and water. So it is about one level lower than dry rubbing. The result. Then colorfulness to pressing, it's a follow the AATCC method 1962. It's a two method, dry test and wet test. In the dry test, the flat iron was placed, set a selected temperature, and in the wet test, the test specimen, a piece of white paste cloth were thoroughly wet in distilled water at the room temperature, and then excess water are removed by pressing. The press cloth was placed on the top of the test specimen and pressed the two for 10 seconds with a flat iron set a selected temperature. The result on the color of the test specimen can be expressed and defined by the refer to the international grayscale by grading samples 1 to 5. Then this is the grayscale for coloring. 1 for very good, 2 means poor, 3 fair, 4 good, and 5 excellent. It's a compare the original samples and tested specimen were placed side by side in the sample plan and originated in the same direction along with the respective grayscale. The visual difference between original and tested specimen in the presence of sunlight at the angle of 45 degrees was compared by the viewing perpendicular to the plane of the surface with the respective grayscale and assigned suitable color fastness rating. And this is the grayscale for staining. 1 for mark stain, 2 considerable stain, 3 noticeable stain, 4 slight stain, and 5 negligible stain. Then this is the furnishing material, which are dye, eco-friendly dyes. It's a natural dye cushion cover, can be embroidered or various other embellishment can be given. And this is the eco-friendly dyed dresses. It's a coat, women's coat and child's coat. It dye are onion dyed. It defined moderns are used. And this is the tie and dye hoodie. Use the turmeric dye also used, and defiant mordant also used. Its effect is the defiant. And this is the indigo dye. And this is the various end product of tie and dye, cushion cover, table mats. Curtains, defiant curtains. Then room divider, rugs. Tie and dyeing process also used as a wallpaper and accessories. And this is the tie and dye upholstery materials. Then block printed products, hoodie, curtain, and different types of upholstery where the block printed used. And from here we come to the end of our session, theory session, and now I will explain practical parts.
Ma'am, you are not audible.
Yeah. Now we start the printing process, the practical form. This is the scout fabrics. Scouring is necessary for evenly penetrate the fabrics. This fabric is scoured with the help of sodium hydroxide and detergent, and it boiled for 1 hour. After scouring, the fabric is dyed and ironed evenly, and after that, the fabric is straightening. The straightening is the most important process in the printing process, especially in the printing process. Straightening is the simplest method of making a fabric grain perfect. Grain means direction of the warp tech and filling tate at the right angles. Right angles means 90 degree angles. And the process of straightening is first pull the thread. First you pull the thread, selvage to selvage. This is here selvage. Selvage is the thick weave portions of the fabrics. And the pull the thread,
surface to surface and pull until the fabric pucker and cut along the pucker line. This is straightening fabrics. It's a regular yarn is got out.
Hello, Sunita.
Omba. Omba.
Heri to focus for it. Mana tumhe bhalke kora nai. Mana heri to.
Etia.
Bhalke. Etia.
Roba ba. Ro. Ek minute. Ek minute ba. Etia ba.
Etia. Ahi se khali tumhe aru akuman. Etu side niya jate bhalke gute kapo kona hai. Hai ba.
Ahi se ba. Thank you, Anenaba.
Aru okoman parile okomiyat koba niki.
Okomiyat ba?
Okoman
majhe. Thik ase.
Eta okomiyat okoman
kosi. Okomiyat kom. Okoman English tam use hobo aru ba?
English tam okoman hobo khali basic technical hobo okoman bujhibo dite
hobo je. Thik ase ba, thik ase. Okay. First ote ami fabric hon scout kori lobo lagibo. আৰু স্কাউৰিং কৰিবলৈ হলে ফেব্ৰিকখন আমি সোডিয়াম হাইড্ৰক্সাইড মানে সোডা এছ আৰু আমি খোৱা সোডাটো ল'ব পাৰোঁ নবা কাপোৰ ধোৱা সোডা ল'ব পাৰোঁ আৰু ডিটাৰজেণ্ট এনি কাইণ্ড অফ ডিটাৰজেণ্ট কিন্তু লাইট কালাৰ ডিটাৰজেণ্ট হ'ব লাগে আৰু আমি ফেব্ৰিকখন বইল কৰিব লাগিব 1 hour কাৰণে আৰু মেটেৰিয়েলটো লিকৰ ৰেচিঅ' ইটছ মিনছ আমাৰ যদি কাপোৰখনৰ ৱেইট 1 gram হয় তেতিয়াহ'লে আমি লিকাৰ মিনছ ৱাটাৰৰ পরিমাণ আমি 30 ml লব লাগিব 1 gram কাপড়ের ওয়েট যদি হয় তেতিয়া হলে আমি কাপড়খনের ওয়েট যদি 1 gram হয় তেতিয়া হলে ওয়াটার আমার পানির পরিমাণ হব লাগিব 30 ml যদি আমার ফর এক্সাম্পল যদি কাপড়খনের ওয়েট আমার 2 grams হয় তেতিয়া হলে ওয়াটারের পরিমাণ কি হব সেটু দুগুণ করব লাগিব তার মানে 60 ml আমার বেসিকটো হইছে 1:30 আমার যিমানখিনি কাপোৰ ওয়েট হব তাত মাল্টিপ্লাই কৰিব লাগিব পূৰণ কৰিব লাগিব 30 লগত ওকে তাৰপিছতে আমাৰ কাপোৰখন অকমান ডেম মানে ভিজি থাকোতে কাপোৰখন আমি আইৰণ মাৰিব লাগিব তাৰ যোনবোৰ ৰিংকলস থাকে যোনবোৰ হুতুমুচু ভাজ থাকে সেইবোৰ আমি অতৰাই পেলাব লাগিব তাৰপিছত কাপোৰখন আমি ষ্ট্ৰেটেনিং কৰিব লাগিব ষ্ট্ৰেটেনিংটো হৈছে কাপোৰখনৰ আমি ইয়াৰ মানে হৈছে থ্ৰেডটো আমি ৱাৰ্প মানে হৈছে যোনখিনি আমাৰ লেংথ ৱাইজত কাপোৰখনত থাকে থ্ৰেড সেইখিনিক আমি ৱাৰ্প থ্ৰেড কওঁ আৰু যোনখিনি আমি কাপোৰখনত ৱেফ্টৰ ফালে থাকে সেইখিনি আমি হৰাইজেণ্টেলভাৱে থাকে সেইখিনি আমি ফিলিং থ্ৰেড বুলি কওঁ সেই ৱাৰ্প আৰু ফিলিং থ্ৰেডটো যে 90 degree এংগুলত থাকিব লাগিব আমি সেইটো চাব লাগিব ফৰ প্ৰিণ্টিং পাৰ্পাছৰ কাৰণে তেতিয়াহে আমাৰ প্ৰিণ্টিংখিনি ষ্ট্ৰেট লাইনত ফৰ্ম হ'ব দেন দিছ ইজ আ প্ৰিণ্টিং বেড একচুৱেলি কনচিষ্ট প্ৰিণ্টিং বেডখন আমাৰ মেইনলি স্পঞ্জৰ হয় যিকোনো স্পঞ্জত ঠিক স্পঞ্জ এটুকুৰা ল'লেই হ'ল আৰু সেইখন কাভাৰ ফেব্ৰিকেলে আমি কভাৰ কৰি ল'ব লাগে সেইটো হৈছে প্ৰিণ্টিং বেড আমাৰ তাৰপিছতে আমি প্ৰিণ্টিং হৈ বেড প্ৰিপেয়াৰ হৈ গ'ল আমাৰ তাৰপিছত কাপোৰখন আমি এতিয়া টাইটলি আমি পিন আপ কৰিব লাগিব 4 corners উইথ পিনেৰে 4 corners আমি টাইটলি পিন আপ কৰিব লাগিব যে ষ্ট্ৰেট হৈ থাকে কাপোৰখন ষ্ট্ৰেট হৈ থাকিবলৈ আৰু ফিট হৈ থাকিবলৈ হ'ল এতিয়া ফাৰ্ষ্টতে মই ষ্টাৰ্ট কৰিম ব্লক প্ৰিণ্টিঙৰ কাৰণে লাগিব আমাক ডিফাৰেণ্ট ব্লকছ এইখন হৈছে ৰাবাৰ চিট য'ত আমি ডাইটো স্পঞ্জ এইখন হৈছে স্পঞ্জ আৰু এইটো ৰডছ আৰু এইটো মই অলৰেডি প্ৰিপেয়াৰ কৰি থৈছোঁ নেচাৰেল ডাই পেষ্ট এনাটো প্ৰিণ্টিং পেষ্ট এই প্ৰিণ্টিং পেষ্টটো প্ৰিপেয়াৰ কৰিবলৈ মই ইউজ কৰিছোঁ এনাটো এক্সট্ৰেকশ্যন 1 teaspoon উইথ 2 teaspoon অফ বাইণ্ডাৰ এণ্ড ফিক্সাৰ এণ্ড 2 teaspoon অফ থিকেনাৰ মই আগতেও কৈছোঁ যে প্ৰিণ্টিং প্লেজৰ আমার যোনটো আমি প্রিন্টিং পেজ বনাও হেতু ব্লক প্রিন্টিং আর স্ক্রিন ব্লক প্রিন্টিং আর স্টেনসিল প্রিন্টিং এর কারণে আমার পেজটো অকমান লিকুইড হয় কিন্তু স্ক্রিন প্রিন্টিং এর কারণে আমার পেজটো অকমান ঠিক হব লাগে তার ঠিকানাটো বেশি দিব লাগে সাপোজ আমি ব্লক প্রিন্টিং এর যদি 1 টিস্পুন অফ ঠিকানার ইউজ কৰিছো তেতিয়া হলে আমি স্ক্রিন প্রিন্টিং এর আমি 3 স্পুন অফ ঠিকানার ইউজ কৰিব লাগিব 3 টাইমস মোর দিস ইজ অ্যানাটো এক্সট্রাক্টেড ডাই পেস্ট তারপরে আমি কত প্রিন্ট করিম হেতু আমি ইকুয়ালি মার্কিং করে লব আমি যত প্রিন্ট করিম মার্ক মার্ক ইট ইকুয়ালি দেন পোর দা প্রিন্টিং প্লেস অন আমি প্রিন্টিং প্লেসটো স্পঞ্জ টুকুৰৰ ওপৰত পেলাই লৈছো তাৰপিছতে ব্লকটো লৈ পেলাই আমি ইভেনলি ব্লকটোত লগাই লম আমি চাব লাগিব যে ব্লকটোত আমি এক্সেছ ডাই লাগি নাহে এক্সেছ লাগি নাহে তাৰপিছতে ব্লকটো আনি আমি য'ত আমাক লাগে নিজৰ জাগাত আমি পেষ্ট কৰিম আৰু যোনখন আমাৰ থাম প্লাম আছে প্লামেৰে আমি হেঁচি দিম আকৌ আমি যাম প্রিন্টিংলৈ পেজটোলৈ লম আকৌ আমি যত লাগে তত আমি প্লাম্পেৰে হেঁচি দিম দিস ইজ দ্য ব্লক প্রিন্টিং ব্লক প্রিন্টিং ব্লকটো আমাৰ এইটো উডেদি বনোৱা হয় আপোনালোকে ঘৰত পটেটো মিনস আলু পাও বনাব পাৰে আলু ডিফাইন শেপ আঁকি পালে আপোনালোকে কাটি পালে আলু পাও বনাব পাৰে নহবা ভেন্দি ইউজ কৰিব পাৰে ডিফাৰেণ্ট টাইপ অফ লিফ ইউজ কৰিব পাৰে আপোনালোকে ব্লক প্ৰিণ্টিঙত দেন কাম টু দ্য স্ক্ৰীণ প্ৰিণ্টিং এখন স্ক্ৰীণ প্ৰিণ্টিঙৰ স্ক্ৰীণ হয় এখন স্ক্ৰীণ প্ৰিণ্টিঙৰ স্ক্ৰীণ হয় কিন্তু মই আজি স্ক্রিন প্রিন্টিং করে দেখাব নোৱাৰিম যেহেতু মোৰ পেজটো অকণমান লিকাৰটো লিকুইড হয় সেইকাৰণে মই জাস্ট কেনেকে কৰে আপোনালোকক গোটেই প্ৰচেছটো দেখাই দিম এখন স্ক্রিন প্রিন্টিং হয় এখন স্ক্রিন প্রিন্টিং উডেন স্ক্রিন প্রিন্টিং হয় এইটো এটা ফ্ৰেম হয় এখন মেচ হয় আগতে এই মেচখন চিল্কৰ আছিলে বাট নাও এ ডেজ ইটস আ মেচ মেড আপ অফ নাইলন আৰু এইটো প্ৰিন্টিঙৰ হৈছে মটিভস আপোনালোকে একৰ্ডিং টু মটিভস এখন দোকানত যিকোনো দোকানতে গৈ পেলাই প্ৰিণ্টিং এনেকুৱা পেজৰ দোকানত গৈ পেলাই বনাই ল'ব পাৰে এখন ঠিক আছে আৰু এখন আপোনালোকে কাপোৰত প্লেচ কৰিব লাগিব আমি এনেকৈ কাপোৰত প্লেচ কৰিম আৰু এডাল হৈছে স্কুইজ স্কুইজডাল আমাৰ উডেন নহবা মেটেলৰ হয় আৰু স্কুইজৰ যোনখন ব্লেড হৈছে এখন ব্লেড বুলি কয় সেইখন ৰাবাৰ ব্লেড হয় আৰু স্কুইজৰ চাইজ এণ্ড প্ৰিণ্টিঙৰ ফ্ৰেমৰ চাইজ ইকুৱেল হ'ব লাগিব মোৰ দেখিছে নহয় ইকুৱেল হয় আমি প্ৰথমতে প্ৰিণ্টিং পেজটো ইয়াতে আমি ফ'ৰ কৰিম ফ'ৰ কৰি আমি স্কুইজাৰে আমি ফ্ৰেমখন এখন হাতেৰে ধৰি স্কুইজাৰে একেবাৰতে আমি এনেকে টানিম স্কুইজাৰত আমি একেবাৰতে এনেকে টানিম টানিলে আপোনালোকৰ যোনটো ডাই থাকিব সেইটো কালাৰ ট্ৰেঞ্চফাৰ হৈ যায় তলৰখনলৈ এইখন হৈছে স্ক্ৰীণ প্ৰিণ্টিং তাৰপিছতে মই দেখাম এতিয়া আপোনালোকক ষ্টেনচিল প্ৰিণ্টিং এখন হৈছে ৰেডিমেড ষ্টেনচিল প্ৰিণ্টিঙৰ কাৰ্ড এখন এভেইলেবল যিকোনো বজাৰতে ফেব্ৰিক কালাৰ পোৱা বজাৰত আপোনালোকে এখন কিনিব পাৰিব আৰু এখন হৈছে হোমমেড স্ক্ৰীণ প্ৰিণ্টিঙৰ কাৰ্ড এখন বনাবলৈ হ'লে আপোনালোকে এখন চাৰ্ট পেপাৰ একৰ্ডিং টু দিয়াৰ ডিজাইনছ এখন চাৰ্ট পেপাৰ কিনি ল'ব লাগিব আৰু চাৰ্ট পেপাৰ্ছখন মেল্ট ৱেক্সত প্ৰথমতে আমি একৰ্ডিং টু দ্য ডিজাইন চাৰ্ট পেপাৰখন কাটি ল'ম আৰু চাৰ্ট পেপাৰত প্ৰথমতে আমি যোনটো মটিভছ লাগে সেইটো আমি প্ৰথমতে ফাৰ্ষ্ট উইড্ৰ কৰিম আমি তাৰপিছতে আমি এখন চাৰ্ট পেপাৰ আমি মেল্ট ৱেক্সত আমি ডুবাম ৱেক্স যিকোনো মম আপোনালোকে ল'ব পাৰে আমি যোনটো ক্যান্ডেল বুলি কওঁ, মম বুলি কওঁ, সেইটোৱে আপোনালোকে ইউজ কৰিব পাৰে। এইটো আপোনালোকে তাত ডুবাব লাগিব। ৱেক্সখন ডুবোৱাৰ পিছত এখন ড্ৰাই হ'বলৈ আমি ফ্লেট চাৰ্ফেচত উইথ প্ৰেচাৰ দি পেলাই থ'ব লাগিব, যে এখন ফ্লেট হৈ থাকে। উইথ প্ৰেচাৰত আমি এখন থৈ যেতিয়া ড্ৰাই হ'ব, আফটাৰ ড্ৰাইং আমি এখন শ্বাৰ্প ব্লেডেৰে য'ত য'ত পেটাৰ্ণ থাকে ত'ত আমি কাটিব লাগিব। কাটিলে আমি এনেকুৱা এখন ষ্টেঞ্চিল কাৰ্ড পাম, আৰু সেইখন আপোনালোকে ষ্টেঞ্চিল কাৰ্ড হিচাপে ইউজ কৰিব পাৰে। অ'কে, এতিয়া মই কিনা কাৰ্ডখনে ইউজ কৰিছোঁ। দেন আকৌ মই ফেব্ৰিকটো ফ'ল্ড কৰিছোঁ এখন প্লেটত। ইয়াৰ কাৰণে আপোনালোকক এডোখৰ সৰু স্পঞ্জ লাগিব, যোনটো দি মই গোটেই কালাৰখন ইয়াত বিয়পাম। এইটো স্পঞ্জ লৈছোঁ, কিন্তু আপোনালোকে চাব লাগিব যে স্পঞ্জ টুকুৰত এক্সেছ ডাই লাগি নাথাকে। মোৰ এতিয়া এক্সেছ ডাই লাগি আছে, মই কি কৰিম, এই এক্সেছ ডাইখিনি আঁতৰাই পেলাম। আঁতৰাই মই এতিয়া ইভেনলি ইয়াত মাৰি যাম। আজিকালি আমাৰ ব্লক প্ৰিণ্টিং শাৰী, স্ক্ৰীন প্ৰিণ্টিং শাৰী, নবা কুৰ্তি বহুত এভেইলেবল হৈছে, আৰু স্পেচিয়েলি আমাৰ যোনটো নেচাৰেল ডাই মানুহৰ কনচাৰ্ণত ই বহুত আমাৰ মানে ডেভেলপ হৈ গৈছে। সেইকাৰণে আপোনালোকে এইটো নিজৰ মানে সুবিধাৰ অৰ্থে নবা বেলেগক এণ্টাৰপ্ৰিনৰশ্বিপ ডেভেলপ কৰিবলৈও আপোনালোকে এইটো ল'ব পাৰে। এতিয়া দেখা পাইছে চাগৈ আপোনালোকে, ইয়াত স্ক্ৰীন প্ৰিণ্টিং কৰিছোঁ মই, ব্লক প্ৰিণ্টিং কৰিছোঁ। আফটাৰ স্ক্ৰীন প্ৰিণ্টিং নহবা ব্লক প্ৰিণ্টিং কৰাৰ পিছত আমি কাপোৰখন ৱাটাৰ ষ্টিমিং কৰোঁ। এটা বাউলত আমি ৱাটাৰ দি পালে তাৰ ভাপটো বাহিৰ হওঁতে আমি কাপোৰখন গেছৰ ওপৰত কাপোৰখন যেতিয়া ভাপ বাহিৰ হয় তেতিয়া আমি কাপোৰখন গৈ আমি ধৰিবগৈ লাগিব, যে এইটো আমি এইকাৰণে কৰোঁ যে ইয়াৰ ডাইটো ইভেনলি পেনিট্ৰেট হ'বলৈ। আমি যেতিয়া তাত ভাপ দিওঁ, ভাপ দিলে কি হ'ব, আমাৰ ফাইবাৰটো ফুলি যায়। ফুলি গ'লে যোনখিনি আমাৰ কালাৰ পিগমেণ্ট আমি কাপোৰত লগাই থৈছোঁ সেইখিনি ফাইবাৰটোৰ ভিতৰত, আঁখখিনিৰ ভিতৰত ধুনীয়াকৈ সোমাই যায়। সেইকাৰণে ফৰ ফিক্সিঙৰ কাৰণে আৰু ৱেল ডাই পেনিট্ৰেশ্যনৰ কাৰণে আমি ষ্টিম দিয়াটো এখন প্ৰিণ্টিং মেটেৰিয়েলত নেচেচেৰী হয়। এয়াই আছিলে আজি প্ৰেক্টিকেল পৰ্চন। দেন কাম টু মাই এণ্ড কাম টু মাই এণ্ড পৰ্চনছ উইথ ডেট আই কাম টু দ্য এণ্ড অফ মাই ট্ৰেইনিং program. As I have already mentioned that market of natural dye is increasing day by day, and as we have many of natural dye sources like available in the market in the Assam, like tea, henna, turmeric, etc. Assam can be major producers of natural dye, provided the upcoming generation get motivated to the entrepreneur in this field. আজি এইখিনি লৈ পেলাই মোৰ প্ৰগ্ৰেমটো মই সামৰণি মাৰিছোঁ। থেংক ইউ,
থেংক ইউ চ' মাছ ডক্টৰ সুনিতা, ইউ হেভ প্ৰেজেণ্টেড চ' ৱেল, ফিউ কুৱেশ্যনছ আৰ দেৰ,
অ'কে বা
ষ্টাৰ্ট, দ্য ফাৰ্ষ্ট ওৱান ইজ দেৰ এনি ৰিলেশ্যনশ্বিপ উইথ নেচাৰেল ডাইজ এণ্ড হিউমেন হেলথ?
ইয়া, নেচাৰেল ডাইজ, আমি যদি এতিয়া মই অসমীয়াতে কৈছোঁ, আমি যদি এতিয়া টাৰ্মাৰিক, মই ফাৰ্ষ্ট আই চে ডেট টাৰ্মাৰিক ইজ এ মেডিচিনেল প্লেণ্ট এণ্ড হেনা অলছো মেডিচিনেল প্লেণ্ট। হেনা আৰু টাৰ্মাৰিকৰ পৰা যদি বনোৱা আমি কাপোৰটো পিন্ধোঁ তেতিয়াহ'লে সেই স্মেলটোতো আমাৰ বডি বহুত এফেক্ট কৰে। কিন্তু চিন্থেটিক ডাই যোনটো আমাৰ বডিৰ কাৰণে হাৰ্মফুল হয়, ইটছ আ চিন্থেটিক।
The next one is natural models, which one is better you have told so many natural modern such as
yes.
iron, copper, alum. Which one is
yes,
better?
Yes.
According to you?
এলাম ইজ দ্য বেটাৰ এণ্ড এলাম মিনছ আমি আমি যোনটো দাড়ি খুৰাওঁতে আগৰ আমাৰ ককাহঁতে ইউজ কৰিছিলে দাড়ি খুৰোৱাৰ পিছত এলাম ইউজ কৰিছিলে সেইটো আমাৰ মানে এতিয়া যোনটো নাও এ ডেজ ইটছ আ পপুলাৰ এণ্ড চেফটি শিলিখা অঁ শিলিখা সেইটো এজ এ ডাই হিচাপে ইউজ কৰিব পাৰে মডাৰ্ণ হিচাপে ইউজ কৰিব পাৰে শিলিখা হেনা এণ্ড টি ইউজ এজ এ ডাই এজ ৱেল এজ ইটছ এজ এ মডাৰ্ণ Yes, ma'am.
The last question is tissue plants are also available in Assam? Tissue plant.
Yeah, but which plant?
Tissue.
Yeah, kesu means kantha. Sorry, kantha. Ami zuntu tamul pano lo. How? Hetu hai. Hello, ba. অনন্যা ম্যাম হ্যালো অনন্যা ম্যাম
কন্টিনিউ
ইয়েস বা এনি আদার কোশ্চেন বা
নো দিস ওয়াজ দ্য লাস্ট ওয়ান থ্যাংক ইউ সো মাচ
থ্যাংক ইউ
নাও আই উড লাইক টু রিকোয়েস্ট ডক্টর অনিতা ফ্লোরা ম্যাম to propose the vote of thanks.
Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Ananya Kashyap, respected principal, Dr. Bipul Chandra Mia, honorable speaker, Dr. Sunita Borua, and my dear colleagues, IQSC and participants. I am honored to have been asked to offer vote of thanks on this occasion. I, on behalf of the Department of Home Science and IQSC, HCB Girls College offer our heartfelt vote of thanks to our principal, Dr. Bipul Chandra Mia, for his untiring support and guidance in organizing this training program. I also take opportunity to express our gratitude to our resource person, Dr. Sunita Borua, for her kind consent to be the speaker in spite of her busy schedule. Thank you so much, Ms. Borua.
Thank you.
We also express our deep sense of appreciation to all the participants for their active participation, without which the program would have been fruitless. Lastly, I offer my vote of thanks to our colleagues, IQSC team, and office staff for their technical support and help. Now, I request Dr. Polat Chandik, coordinator, IQSC, to speak a few words about upcoming events of our college. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Anita Thakur, madam. I, on behalf of the IQSC, would like to offer our gratitude to today's resource person, Dr. Sunita Borua, madam, for your kind cooperation and for your very illustrative presentation regarding a very relevant topic, particularly for the young and aspiring women who want to be an entrepreneur in their own in their future. So I, on behalf of IQSC, again thank you, madam. I also offer gratitude to our principal sir for his inaugural speech, as well as I also thank Department of Home Science, faculty member of Department of Home Science, Dr. Anita Thakur and Dr. Ananya Kashyap, for they are active participants in the whole program. And I also offer our gratitude to my colleague, assistant coordinator Sumit Sharma, for his technical support, and other faculty members of our college. Last but not the least, I offer sincere gratitude to all the participants. Those are very much actively participate and try to grab the opportunity which we have provide to get some web-based training knowledge about a very important topic. I just want to announce that we have a series of webinars. We have already done six webinars and one training program. In the afternoon also today, we have another webinar on which is organized by jointly IQAC and Department of English. Tomorrow also we have one lecture program and one webinar, and 3rd of July we have another webinar, and we have lots of activities. In near future, we'll communicate the other people. There will be various other activities which we'll organize in near futures. I request participants to participate these programs in the near future. I again thank all for your active participation. Now I request and I formally announce that today's WBT program is finished here. I request thank Sumit Sharma to close the proceeding. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.